Police came on Memorial Day. 99 years before, that same week, black Americans suffered a massacre. In the days after World War I, a neighborhood in Tulsa, Oklahoma, called Greenwood, was among the wealthiest black communities. Oil made Greenwood rich, but jealousy made it suffer. In 1921, a white mob with incendiary rage burned Greenwood to ash. Even memories were murdered when the dead were dropped into unmarked graves. Last December, before the pandemic, we found Tulsa preparing to embrace a reckoning with a plan to exhume the truth and raise the dead.
The story will continue in a moment.
The community that is Greenwood has thriving businesses, professional offices, doctors, lawyers, dentists.
The history of John W. Franklin speaks of Greenwood in the present tense.
Greenwood is the nexus of that African-American community.
Perhaps because he studied Greenwood in 32 years as a historian at the Smithsonian, or likely because Greenwood is personal.
And my grandfather moves here from Rentersville in February 1921. And he's the first person in the family to go to college, Buck Colbert Franklin.
Buck Colbert Franklin was a lawyer who chased his dream to a promised land. Booker T. Washington named Greenwood Negro Wall Street because the district was lined with black-owned shops, restaurants, two newspapers, a 54-room grand hotel, a hospital, and the Dreamland Theater, which would soon boast air conditioning. But on the day after Memorial Day, 1921, Buck Franklin awoke to fearful news.
He hears that there's to be possibly a lynching. There's this black man who's been caught with this white woman in the elevator, and the newspapers are saying, read all about it. There's extra, read all about it.
Tulsa's white newspapers told of a black teenager who allegedly attacked a white female elevator operator. At the jail, a lynch mob demanded the prisoner. Black veterans of World War I arrived to shield the defendant for his day in court. A shot was fired, and in a running gun battle, the mob chased the black vets to Greenwood.
One of the moments during the riot that your grandfather wrote about was this. On they rushed, whooping to the tops of their voices, firing their guns every step they took. What is it like for you to read those words today?
He too was traumatized by seeing people being shot in front of his eyes. He describes a woman who's trying to find her child, who's run in front of her. And she's unafraid of the bullets raining down because her concern is to find her child.
What began as an attempted lynching at the jail erupted into a massacre. From a high grain elevator, a machine gun laid fire on Greenwood Avenue.
Where's the fire department? Where's the police when we need them? We're part of a city. This is not some small town. This is a city of wealth and order and governance. It is now taken over by a mob.